Yeah, I know, I know, I know. Yeah, that's my first statement. If you aren't good, oh damn it! If you got. So, guys, first here with another video of today. We're back at War Thunder, and since last week, we got some special events going on about War Thunder ships being added soon. Currently, it's just a closed beta test. Yeah, how do you get access to them? Link will be in the description below again. You can either buy access to them or send an invitation, I don't know how it's called, to Gaijin themselves and hope that they allow you. I bought it a few months ago, so I'm already prepared. Which leads me to the following. Now we're going to use the Russian ship first, but one thing I did get this anchor, and that's from the ship's close beta, Russian anchor. I don't know if there's a special decal. I think there was special. Yeah, I don't know. Was there? I don't know, to be honest. This is alpha, beta. What? Oh, Guinness Book of World Records, nice. USSR maybe? I have no idea. But we're going to use the German or the Russian ships first. There will be two of them. So far I noticed. One of them is very interesting. Right, that was an awkward moment, but Russian ships, we're going to use them now. There are two of them, one I think both having DSHKMs and torpedoes. I'm not sure yet, but we'll see. And that's it, straight into the event. Alright everyone, welcome to the first battle, where we are now using the G-5 as first. And this is quite a fast thing for speed and power. Kind of looks like a submarine, does it? Where are the torpedoes? Now we will see. It's a small, fast little thing. Can I see the torch? Nope. I only ate the machine guns. Torpedoes are everything for this thing. Enemy forces have captured a zone. Because I can't use these engine guns. Oh, reload seriously. Ah! Fuck. Hit! I have no idea why my torpedoes didn't drop though. Oh. I'm dead. Why didn't my torpedoes drop though? That's a little weird. Alright, now let's try. Oh! Oh! How the fuck does that... Wait. How does that work even? That is a weird thing. Russians are weird.
The enemy has taken
The Russians are very weird. And I'm on fire. And my only gunner is dead. Fuck you! Fuck you! Oh snap. Oh fuck. I'm dead. This G-5 is a weird thing. I don't like it. Alright. New rounds, new chances. I hate the torpedo use on this thing. Come here. And I'm on fire. Fuck me. Be dead. Aha. What the? What? I hate this thing. Alright. Lastly, the airplane. And then we will go to the second battle where we use the D3. Looks a lot more interesting. Although, it looks more interesting, but it's really not that good either. I can't wait till the higher tier vehicles. Only it's... 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 This is a nice easy way to get some free cash. Because I keep making hits, but not kills. Can I reload? Yes I can. Oh, damn. On to the next battle with the D3. Alright everyone, welcome to the second second gameplay. For this time we will be using the D3, another Russian ship for BR 1.7. I don't know if that battle rating will be permanent, most likely not, but okay. But first I have two opinions to say. Firstly, about the Russian low tier ships. That's the only one I used so far. And second, of the ships overall. I'm sure it's the low tier Russian ships, like the G-3 and the G-5 and the D-3. The ships are fun and all, but these two ships, so far I tested myself, really don't have a lot of use. Because yeah, you got some powerful torpedoes, yes. And this one does have some good depth charges. But yeah, if you look at the armament, it just got two DSHK machine guns. What the fuck just happened? Holy fuck. Alright, second try. But the armament isn't really that great. It just has two DSHKs, DSHKMs, I forgot, as defensive, as AAs, because I got key bindings for them. And two 533mm torpedoes, which you can see on the side. But yeah, if you can't aim the torpedoes, you can't really do much, because firstly, well, I'm not going to launch them yet, because if you launch them, they firstly launch off, and then they actually go forward. And as you saw by the G5, it was a whole complex story, because torpedoes were literally mounted in the back. So if you wanted to launch torpedo, they firstly move off the ship, lower a little, then they get activated, which causes them to move forward under the ship, but because they are not activated yet, they don't really do something. But yeah, it's a whole complex system of using torpedoes wisely. Because you can do that, but if you can't aim, you can't use them. And that's pretty much my story about them. Because I don't like that pre-aiming. Same on the ships, tanks, and planes. But yeah, it needs to be done. And also, yeah, like now, yeah, I got... Oh. Dying! That was a close one. Done. Fuck you. But yeah, as I was saying, if you can't lead with your torpedoes, same with tanks, with planes, for everything pretty much, you can't use them. Because you can have it, but if you can't use it, it's useless. Just like, for example, you have the mouse as ground vehicle, but it's a top tier. It's sluggish as hell, it goes really slow. The 128mm cannon does pretty much no damage. The 75 it has does more, but has less pen, so that's the problem. But yeah, with only two 12.7mm machine guns, you can't really do much. And I can choose my binoculars. Yeah, if I look at, that's the higher tier vehicle I already used last week. And there's someone behind me. Last week they had a C-34, as it was called. Yeah, not literally called, but people call it that way. Because it has two T-34 turrets with, I believe, the 85mm cannons, but I am not sure. Maybe the 76. We'll see when it comes again. But yeah, that one was a lot more interesting to play. Because not only it had just the normal DSHKs, it also had two T-34 turrets. Which were pretty, pretty well. I like them. So, in low tier, the Russian ships are pretty useless. As I'm shooting right here, but I'm not really doing any damage. And we got a hull breach. And I'm gonna turn my ship a little. And one. Two. Yeah, I know. But yeah, that's my first statement. If you aren't good... Oh, damn it. If you gotcha, mother trucker. But if you aren't good with using the tanks, with the cannons, you aren't really going to do you can't really do something with these ships. And well, besides that 40mm cannons, or 76. Yes, yes. It also had two 45s, I believe. I'm not sure, and two DSHKMs. And those are pretty awesome. There's also one premium. Oh. Ouch. There was also one premium ship I bought. I didn't use it yet, because I wasn't allowed to yet. Launch some torpedoes. But yeah, that one was pretty interesting as well, because it had one T-34 turret, a dual 40mm cannons, but also, yeah, I knew it, but also one Katyusha launcher with 60 rockets, I believe. And so far I know, that will be the only ship with rockets. I don't know for sure yet, I can't promise anything, but we'll see. We aren't that far yet, so it's still the closed beta, last week released. Are you fucking serious? I just found him by another Dutch guy. Alright, that's but that's what I think about it, about low tier Russians. Now the ships in overall, they are fun, because yeah, you can see it, I'm having fun with them. So far these are the only ones I am recording. So I didn't use them a lot last week one time, before I started recording one time, and two times now when I'm recording. Of course I will be playing this off camera too, because I really like this. But yeah, the ships are fun. I can't wait to see what they have more. Because the only thing I used were the Russians and a bit of the Germans last week. And those Russians, the Germans were pretty funny as well. Just because the way they play. And no, don't shoot me, please. So I can't wait to see the future of Warfare, eh? Critical hits. Because that ships added in War Thunder completely will be lots of fun. But now only seeing some low tier ships from every nation, two at a time. For Japan, one so far I know. Oh yeah, kill. That isn't really interesting. Because you can't really use much variation in the battles. Like, unlike with planes and tanks currently, you have lots of vehicles, so lots of variation to play. And with soon the Japanese tanks to be added, which I really want the Holy One and Two. Those are amazing, but I'm not sure if they are both prototypes. So we need to, I don't know who wants them more, but we need to hope on them. But yeah, if they get added, I'm going to grind them for sure. Of course I'm going to grind them for YouTube, but hey, beached. He is beached. But yeah, I really like the ships in War Thunder, especially in the future, because they said they won't add any battleships, like yeah, actual battleships, cruisers, light and heavy cruisers, CVs. They won't add that until the status of the CBT comes close. So if this turns out well, they might add it in the future. If not, they will never add it. Keep your fingers crossed, because I really want to use my Iowa. Because I really enjoy Iowa. I also, yeah, I don't have it in World of Tanks or World of Tanks, but in World of Warships and Steel Oceans, but I would really like it. Because they are amazing. And the kill assist. Main reason, ships are fun for itself. But that serious amount of armor, Jesus, that will create such a chaos to them. Why am I so good? Normally I'm not this good. But yeah, that will be extremely fun. I need to keep talking till this match is finished, god damn it. Nope, fuck off. But yeah, I would like that. I don't know who wants ships more. What would be your nation you would grind? Because to be honest, I have no idea yet. They all seem interesting. I do have a Russian premium, so I might use the Russians first to see a little how they play. That was close. And after that, go a little after. But yeah, I need to look how the CBT goes, of course, what I like the most. Because so far, I like Russian high tiers, but you don't get Russian high tiers in just 1 second. You need actually time in it. So yeah, that's a little bit of a worry. I want to do something that's good at low tier as well. Low tier and high tier. Because I want something to have fun all the time in the tech tree. Unlike the American tanks. American tanks are fun in high tier but not in low tier. Which is the problem. Now, the Shermans are fun in a group, but I mostly play alone, so I need something that is good for playing alone. And why aren't there any ships anymore? God dang it. Let's see, but the ships will be interesting, can't wait. Will play more, also play more for YouTube, of course. Ah, fuck. Yeah. We need to wait. The closed beta just started last week, so it might take a little longer. I wonder when the Japanese things come out. Because I'm still waiting on that. Where are you? He disappeared, didn't he? There he is! But yeah, those are my opinions about it. And I really enjoy this match, really. I have no idea where we are. African girl. So, I really like this map. Is there an airfield? No, there isn't. I can't wait till Waffender adds more ships, maybe even battleships in the future. Who knows? And my engine is overheating. No fun. So, also a question that I saw recently: what would you like to see Waffender over 3 years, and how would it be? Well, I would love to see Waffender over 3 years to see how everything went. If they finally added my privateer, that thing is so beautiful. It is pretty much a B-24 Liberator, but only better. So that's something I really enjoy. Gunships maybe in the future, like the YX-40. The YX-40 is a customized B-17 with a two dual turrets on top and a dual turret on each side for gunship purposes. Of course. Fuck. For gunship purposes and for bomber export. For bomber escorts. Is he dead? He's dead. So that will be interesting. Look at that guy chilling. Can't wait to see what they will bring. Because it will be very interesting to see Warfen over 3 years. What they didn't know. Because currently there are so many devlogs going out, which I really want to see. So, that was a little bit of gameplay, my opinions about them. Hope you guys enjoyed watching, and see you at the next time.